Yes, hire me, Susan. You seem unable to understand them. I will not tell them to you again. You will continue with your singing.
This is probably one of my favorite scenes from 1942's Citizen Kane, for a few reasons. One, the use of high and low camera angles to illustrate position of power between the characters, and two, the lighting. Throughout Citizen Kane, Greg Toland, the cinematographer, uses these high and low camera angles and obscure lighting to create this dramatic effect that not only grabs the viewer's attention, but immerses them. Toland's contribution to the film was so significant that director Orson Welles even shared an end credit sequence with Toland. In On the History of Film Style by David Bordwell, he writes, "The director directs not just the actors and the crew, but also the viewer's attention. I think the same thing could be applied to a director of photography like Greg Toland." In Citizen Kane, Toland uses lighting as a tool for directing attention, with a more natural and stationary effect. Essentially the opposite of a theater show or a sitcom, where lighting follows the character and keeps them well lit throughout the show. In the film, the lighting can be seen beaming down on a specific character to draw attention to them, but when the characters move, the light doesn't. This not only establishes the mood of uncertainty and mischief in the scene, but also creates a more natural feel for the environment. In Toland's book, The Motion Picture Cameraman, he writes, "The lighting of a scene is an equally potent factor in the determination of dramatic effect, in addition to its basic function, visibility." In Citizen Kane, Toland is using visibility and the lack of it to direct the viewer's attention to the more important elements of the scene. For example, in the scene where Mrs. Kane meets Susan, Mr. Kane's mistress, lighting is used to set a mood of uncertainty for the characters in this intense scene. But lighting is also showing who currently possesses the power when they are speaking in or out of the light. This not only reinforces the audience's direction, but this is also a sense of synergy among lighting and camera angles.
Hello, Jedediah.
I'm drunk.
Well, if you got drunk to talk to me about Miss Alexander, don't bother.
There are a variety of camera angles in Citizen Kane, but the one that sticks out most to me is the low camera angle. In some scenes, the low camera angle is more noticeable than in others. There are some scenes where the low angle is at a drastically low point of view, and in others it's less noticeable when it's at the character's waist level.
Close the door.
Going back to the previous scene, the low camera angle is used for a few reasons. Could be to illustrate the character's equal position of power in the scene, or also as a way of giving a point of view for the audience. The way we witness this interaction among the characters is at a low vantage point, maybe as a way of separating us from their level of status, or maybe giving us a perception of the events as they correlate to the balance of power in the room.
For you and this public thief to take the love of the people of this state away from me?
Charlie. You got other things to think about. Your little boy. You don't want him to read about you in the papers.
There's only one person in the world to decide what I'm going to do, and that's me.
In his book, The Motion Picture Cameraman, Greg Toland wrote, "Of all the people who make up a movie production unit, the cameraman is the only one who can call himself a free soul. He is certainly the least inhibited." With the combination of camera angles and lighting, Toland has created a more natural setting for the audience that not only grabs our attentions, but with the elements of ambiguity from the camera angles, it leaves us on the edge of our seats, feeling immersed.